groom who kills the bride. Amen. 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 One, two, three, jump.
So even like I was saying, a recipe, you know, you have to refer back to that recipe because you don't remember every step to that, to bake or make that thing. So you have to have a guidance of in writing so you won't, you can actually have a reference and be able to remember every, you know, something to go. You have to read the book to get Bubba Cook. To get the book Bubba Cook, you got to read the book. You know what I mean? So without scripture in the Bible, how would you know God?
Celebration of ushering. So those who are ushering today have been challenged. But here's the theme they chose. With God, all things are possible. Mark 10, verse 27. With God, all things are possible. Even things that are hard, even ushering in COVID-19 pandemic world, our ushers did it.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
So you want to show out, act like you ain't never done nothing. But for all the real people like Pastor T, can you thank God he washed all your sins away? Am I the only one? Okay. I know where I've been, and you do too, honey child. You better thank God in here. Sitting up here trying to look all cute behind a mask like you've been good all your life. The devil is a lie. You better thank God that he poked you to come back to church. And when you came back, he washed all your sins. I got to go past the
glam. Jesus wants us to grow from the age of 12 to the age of 30 to the age of 50 if we need to prepare ourselves to do his work. I hope and pray that more young people in our church will decide to become lay members in the church so that they can pray and preach and serve. Young people, I love you. In the name of Jesus Christ this morning, I offer this message to you. Amen.
And telling the truth is the biggest factor in grown folks. Grown folks. And you wonder where our children get it from when you sit around the table and tell all kind of things and they listen. My father used to say, go outside, y'all. And we said, why he want us to go outside? And don't be around that door. Don't be listening up in here. But see, they hear too much. Then when they grow up, they don't respect you. Why? Because they done saw you. They heard you. You know.
These all died in faith, not having received the promises, but having seen them afar off, were assumed of them, embraced them, and confessed that they were strangers and pilgrims on the earth. This is the word of God. Thanks be to God. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to go ahead and read from the Shona Bible, from Vaheburu 11, verse 1, kushika 13. Zvino kutenda ndiko kunova nechokwadi nezvinhu zvatinotarisira nechiratidzo chezvinhu zvatisingaoni.
We thank Pastor Grandma for allowing us this time to come and share with one another so we can't forget
when we walk, leave today, when we go to the right or the left, or we go forward or we go backward, we need to reach out to somebody that pull them up along with us. Let them know, but God, those who are out there running, stop. It's time to stand still. Those who are sick, God, massage their body. Massage them, heal them, Lord. Make their body free, Lord. Lord Jesus, we're just so excited today. And I ask for you, to God, to touch me. I've been going through some things for a couple months, but God, I know you're able, and I know you haven't left me. You'll never leave me, I know. So God, I thank you for whatever's coming. I thank you for how you're going to do it. I thank you for when I fall down, you pick me up. When I turn around and I don't know who I am, you let them know that you're God, and God all by yourself.
Lazarus, take him in and care for him. The rich man had a heart, his heart was hard despite his great blessing. The amount of money we have is not as important as the way we use it. What is your attitude towards your money and possession? Do you hoard them selfishly or do you use them to help others? In Jesus' name, amen.
You got to protect yourself, and you. If some people are not as nice and kind as God want them to be, and you understand, yeah. You got to protect yourself, and you got to make sure you be where you want to be. Be wherever you let grandma or your father know you're at, correct?
Yeah.
And that you can't get on the internet and go on all these funny, crazy websites, correct?
Yeah.
And make people, people has a tendency to take young girls and mess their mind and play mind games with them on their cell phones and on this internet. So you got to be very, very what? Say safe.
Safe.
Okay?
A church that has no empty pews, who preacher never has a blue, a church who deacons always speak, and I'm as proud as all of me. Where gossip never paddle lies, or may compliment or criticize, where all are always sweet and kind, and all to others' advantage align. Such perfect churches there may be, but none of them are known to me. But still we work, pray, and plan to make this one the best we can.
So many things that are distracting children from accomplishing what they should accomplish in education, because they are being distracted by video games. They are being distracted by what, movies. But there's so many things.
Yeah.
But I'm urging you parents who are watching, listen, I've been working with humankind. There was a missionary. He is now in Virginia. He invited me when I came to the United States. Come, Rev. When he was in Zimbabwe, TV was popular. He was raising his children. This is a white guy. He says to his children, no TV, education. It sounds strange, is it not? For your information, parenting is not being permissive. in allowing your child to be distracted. Parenting is a serious business. Allow your children to stay focused. Church is a serious business.
All right, okay. Skylar, I baptize you in the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let's give an applause.
People who would say when they see a really old tree, or maybe a large oak, or even a towering poplar tree, which is a popular tree in our region, amen, they might say that this tree has seen or heard some things. I'm not sure if you've ever heard that saying, but I've heard it before. So in this message today, I have three main points that I will focus on. One is that we must trust God. Two is that God is our refuge. And three is that we have hope in God.
Is that enough? Hence the question, is the bread of life at your table tomorrow? Is the bread of life at your table tomorrow? You may have all this good food, but don't you need the bread of life at your table? Jesus said, I am the bread of life.
We thank you, God. We thank you, God, that the young people are standing here as the children of God, as humans created in the image of God, as young people who need direction from the Holy Spirit. God, we thank you.
We would have loved almost every person in the church to come forward and to congratulate the parents. But we are trying to make sure that we keep protocols. And I was even thinking, should these leaders shake hands on your behalf? Maybe they can just say hello, thank you.
We accept this communication equipment as a sacred trust and will guard and use it reverently.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, we consecrate this communication equipment to the glory of God. Let's pray. God, we thank you for providing resources for us as we do ministry in your kingdom. We thank you, God.
Three people that had coronavirus start off with in America. From them three people. Look how it spread. Imagine this. What if on this night, God was to fill us with the Holy Spirit, that we become spiritually contagious to ourselves and those we come into contact with? This is what the revival is about. We become spiritually contagious where wherever we go, whoever we touch, it's with the Holy Spirit.
We light these candles, the candle of joy and hope, of proclaimed peace, of deep everlasting joy, and today of presence that speaks of love, as a sign that no matter our circumstances, we know we are not alone.
The little sheep once more comes up to the manger and says,
what?
That's Emmanuel. That's God with us. We are not alone.
There's a sweet spirit in this place.
Tell me, one of you,
what you like most about Christmas. Just mention one thing. Who is ready to say something? What do you love about Christmas? Yes, 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 yes.
Going to my grandparents' house for the weekend in matching pajamas.
There was the line leader who had the responsibility of getting us to our destination. In our spiritual lives, we have a destination, the place that God has called us to, the ministry and the works that he's called us to, the blessing that he has put our names on, the miracles that he has put forth in our lives. But yet the world wants us to put other things before Jesus. It wants us to put other things in its way. And sometimes it happens. I look down at my life sometimes and I see Jesus back behind a few things where he shouldn't be. And I need to remind myself that it is time to take Jesus from back down the line and make him the line leader.
You know, as we look around at our church, we see that our church is dwindling. And today we have that new hope, new faith, and new joy because of the children we see here in the congregation. Pastor told us just to be quiet, don't fear, and don't let your heart faint.
God is so good. Micah Pumvut, keep on keeping on, because the kingdom of God is here. Reverend Kapumvut, kusvika pamaropa. Cheche ya mwari ino chengetwa. Sekuti dzidzisa kwamaita. The kingdom of God is here. I also want to thank your family, your children. Even if they are not here, hopefully they will hear that we've been thanking them. They sacrificed a lot. They sacrificed quality time with you for the sake of this kingdom. I hope that the Lord will reward them mightily. I pray that their prayers will be answered. I pray that the Lord will open doors for them so that someone can be a witness, someone can testify that indeed the children of those who commit themselves to the Lord faithfully are blessed. Because that just fulfills the word of God. I have not seen the righteous forsaken or their children begging for bread. So today as we celebrate, I wish you nothing but the blessings of God in abundance. I wish you nothing but life in the fullness of it as Jesus declares it to you and your children and to those who take the call of God seriously. Peace be with you. The blessings of the Lord be with you as we disciple and journey together in response to God's calling.